this resolution, you send a message. You send a message that it's time for the US and the UK to leave, but to leave responsibly, and to do in the next 6 months what they failed to do in the last 33.
James Ugby, thank you very much indeed. What Arab League initiative? They've been conspicuously silent and conspicuously inactive.
Well, actually,
Iraq is
they haven't
concerned.
Been. They haven't been, Tim. There was a meeting held in Cairo, and I think
they meet and they talk.
No,
but that's
they
it.
Brought
isn't
together
it?
Iraqi groups. They brought together the surrounding countries. The problem is that it was a useful discussion. A very useful discussion.
What
and
have
it was,
they done apart well, from talk?
The point
what
is that they
done?
Haven't the mandate or the power to do, and that is what is required. It needn't be the Arab League, but it ought to be the UN.
They
it
haven't
ought,
got the agreement or the consensus. That's the point.
The point
it?
Is that there wasn't an agreement or consensus in Eastern Europe when we created a regional security pact that did provide stability in Eastern Europe. This region requires a regional security pact. And it can come about, but it can't come about under a US-UK umbrella. And that's the problem right now. The US has become a target and has become such a source of anger in the region that it hasn't got the legitimacy to do. That hurts
right,
me
okay.
as an American to say that, but the reality is that's where we
okay,
are.
Okay, those who advocate an early withdrawal do not know what is at stake. The huge investment in blood and money sacrificed by the US could be squandered. That is from the Iraqi foreign minister. Why do you think you know better than he does?
As an American, I know that my country hasn't a plan, didn't have a plan. The dictator's gone. The job is done. It's time to leave. The Iraqi people have to solve this on their own. We can no longer be enabling. We've become like methadone right now for the various sects in Iraq.
Jim.
We are providing them the cover to carry out their existing. Look, when we have to go in and Americans go in and liberate prisons in Iraq and find people tortured, it hurts. But at the same time, what hurts me even more is that we don't have the legitimacy and credibility to complain. We did it ourselves. This is bad all the way around. It was conceived in sin, and no good can come of it. That's the problem.
Okay. James Ugby, thank you very much. Let me now call on Ali Al-Bayati to speak against the motion, please.
Thank you very much.
Tonight, Iraq's future is in your hand. And the future of the women in Iraq is in your hand. So please vote for stability, security, and after all, democracy. Ladies and gentlemen, the unmitigated disastrous policies that was adopted by the previous regime resulted in 8 years of war against Iran. It resulted in the use of chemical weapons against the Kurds in the north, the crushing of the uprising in the south, and the crushing of the uprising in the Ramadi, the west of the area in Iraq. Those policies has resulted in a regime that defied the whole world. The coalition forces went against the regime, removed it, and subsequently Iraq went under occupation. That occupation ended legally by United Nations Resolution 1546 on the 30th of June 2004. An interim government came in power. That government had a duty. The duty was to have a general election on the 31st of January 2005. 8.5 million people went to the ballot boxes defying all terrorist activities in Iraq. The interim government came and went. Now we have a transitional government for 1 year. The duty for that government is this. First is to have a constitution that is ratified by the Iraqi people, which they did on the 15th of October 2005. The second duty, it's a general election that will elect a permanent government that will be a constitutional government that will stay in 4 years. That constitutional government will have the right to ask the multinational forces to leave when it see the situation suits. If the multinational forces leave immediately, we're going to have a vacuum. We don't want that. We want the Iraqi forces to be up and running, to have enough arms, to have enough practice in order to have security and stability in Iraq, and to be able to run and attack all the terrorists who are in the government, who are at the moment attacking government places, attacking innocent people, attacking women, children, and so on. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you to vote for security and stability in Iraq. Thank you very much.
Ali Abayati, thank you very much. What security and stability do you have when people are being killed hand over fist in your country?
The security.
How do you interpret that as security and stability?
The vacuum that was created by the occupation resulted in no security at all because they have completely demolished the X system, they demolished the police, the army, and so on. We've got to rebuild that.
But you haven't got security and stability, and your constitution, which you think is pretty wonderful, has not protected anybody and given them security. It's a piece of paper that is not respected by the insurgents.
The democratic political process that's going on will ensure the stability and security, given enough time for the Iraqi forces and Iraqi security forces to have enough practice in order to keep security.
How much time?
We need enough time to have it up and running.
How much time, Ali Abayati?